We all know about the American Indians and what happened to them, you know, which was crazy, crazy stuff going on there. But there were some things about American Indians that I'd forgotten about, or at least maybe never really knew quite what they were like before, you know, the settlers came over. And I'm going to share some of that with you right now on this episode of the Steve Thomas Show. Have you ever met an American Indian? I have a couple times in my whole life. That's about it. My grandfather was not an American Indian, but back in the 60s, I remember, you know, as a kid, he would find arrowheads all over the place. This is down the country, Missouri-Arkansas border. He'd find an arrowhead, you know, in the dirt, commonly, and pick it up and, oh, look, arrowhead, and just throw it. That's how common they were. That's how common Indians used to be. But we all know the story of what happened, you know, Trail of Tears and basically genocide of the American Indian. But before we came along, you know, it wasn't like the cowboys and Indian movies, you know, that we used to watch as kids, or, you know, maybe some of you still do. Because there were some things that we just took for granted that the Indians didn't have till the white man came. If you're like most people, you know, you remember things of movies and TV shows with the Indians riding around on horses. Well, guess what? There were no horses in the United States of America before it was the United States of America, before it was even settled. The Spanish brought them over only about 500 years ago, which is really not that long, you know, considering in the history of human civilization. Yep, and that's what happened. The Spanish actually brought over horses in boats. And the Indians were just, you know, until then, walking around, carrying everything. They might have had canoes. I don't really know about that. Doesn't matter. But they didn't have horses. They had a lot of these, but they didn't have horses. So they would just walk around and carry their stuff. But one of the craziest things to think about is what's up next. You know, they didn't have these either. That's right. Wheel. The wheel was not something that the Indians had. They carried their stuff around. They didn't have horses. They didn't have wheels or axles, you know, until much, much later, after the American Indians became aware of the white settlers coming in, and then they'd see them, but hey, it's a horse. And some of them got loose, wild horses, and they caught those, some of them, they tried, and they rode those damn things. So now they could get around. So they didn't have horses, they didn't have the wheel. They had peyote, and they had peace pipes. You do some peyote and you're going to see God or something, I'm sure. So they didn't have anything that the settlers brought, including stuff like the plague. And the Indians ended up giving away or losing most of their land, and then eventually all of their land, you know, to the white settlers or the white man, and thus the Trail of Tears. Crazy stuff, absolutely. You know, so they were just minding their own business, not really hurting anyone except maybe each other, and here we go. Here comes the white man, and it's all gone. Do you really know any Indians? I've met one or two Indians. There's not a hell of a lot of them left, so I don't know, man. That's the story of the Indians and the things that I didn't think about until just recently. This is Steve Thomas. Subscribe to the show. Be safe. Smoke with an Indian. Goodbye.
motivation. Though I wear a shirt and tie, I'm still part red man deep inside. Cherokee people, Cherokee tribe, so proud to live, so proud to die. But maybe someday when they've learned.